Welcome students, today we will do question number 6 and question number 7 of exercise 6.5. Question number 6 is ABC is an equilateral triangle of side 2A. Find each of its attitudes. We are given an equilateral triangle ABC and we have to find its altitude. He has asked us to find each of its altitudes, and we know that in equilateral triangle all the three altitudes are equal, so we'll find one altitude. Say we'll find this altitude 80, and if we can find 80, then all of the three altitudes will be equal to the length of AD. So let us do. In given, we'll write an equilateral triangle ABC with side equal to 2A, and we have to find altitude AD. We have in triangle ADB and ABC. First of all, we'll prove that triangle ADB and triangle ADC are congruent triangle. First of all, we have to prove this. Here, angle ADB is equal to angle ADC. This is angle ADB and this is angle ADC. Both of these angles are 90 degree each, because AD is altitude and altitude makes an angle of 90 degree with the base. Therefore, these angles are equal, because both of these are 90 degree each. AB equal to AC. This AB is equal to this AC, and here AB and AC are corresponding sides also, and these are equal because ABC is an equilateral triangle. So all of three sides of it are equal, therefore AB is equal to AC. And also AD, first two letters here, first two letters again AD, and this is common. This AD is a side of both of these triangles, that is AD is side of ADB as well as side of triangle ABC. Therefore these two triangles become congruent by RHS congruency criteria. One angle is a right angle, and hypotenuse is equal, and one side of these two triangles other than hypotenuse is also equal. So these triangles get congruent by RHS criteria. Therefore VD equal to CD, because these are corresponding sides, and we will write in the reason why CPCT. CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangle. This we have done in 9th class, that is corresponding parts of congruent triangles are always equal, and these are corresponding sides. Now BC is equal to BD plus CD. We can see from the figure this BC is made by BD and CD together. Now this BC is 2A, because it is given that this is an equilateral triangle ABC, each of its side is 2A, so BC is 2A. And here BD and CD comes as such. In the next step, this 2A is equal to BD plus BD. We have used question number 1, where we have proved that BD is equal to CD. This BD is equal to CD, so we can write BD here per CD. Now BD plus BD, 2BD, and this 2 will cancel this 2, and we will get A equal to BD, which implies BD equal to A. This is question number 2. Now we have found that this BD is A, and we are given that this AB is 2A. So now we can find this AD by Pythagoras theorem. In triangle ADB, by Pythagoras theorem, AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square, because AB is hypotenuse here and it is 2A and BD is A. In the next step, 2A square is 4A square is equal to AD square plus A square, and now we will shift this A square to the left side, it will become minus A square. 4A square minus A square equal to AD square, and in the next step we get AD square equal to 3A square. which implies these three as square can be written as square of under root 3a, because root 3 square is 3 and a square is a square. And after this we will cancel this square for this square, and we get ad equal to root 3a, or we can write this ad in the left side and this root 3a in the right side, which implies altitude equal to root 3a. This was to be calculated. Now let us see question number 7. Question number 7 is, prove that sum of the squares of the sides of a rhombus is equal to the sum of the square of its diagonals. We are given a rhombus. Say it is ABCD. We have given this name ourselves. Figure is not given. We have drawn our rhombus. Say it is figure 1.1. And we have to prove that sum of the squares of its side is equal to the sum of the squares of its diagonal. That is AB square plus BC square plus CD square plus DA square. These are four sides of this rhombus, and we have to prove that this sum is equal to the sum of squares of diagonals. That is first diagonal AC and second diagonal BD. AC square plus BD square. This is to be proved. Now in proof, first of all we will write that we know diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angle. That is diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other, also they bisect at right angle. Means here triangle AOB, VOC, COD, DOA, all of these four triangles are right triangles, because diagonals bisect and also bisect at right angles. Therefore diagonals bisect, which means that AO is equal to CO and OB is equal to OD. Therefore we get OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD, because diagonals of rhombus bisect each other. Now by Pythagoras theorem in triangle AOB, we'll use Pythagoras theorem four times. First in triangle AOB, then in triangle VOC, then in triangle COD, and finally in triangle DOA. We have to use PGT four times. And then we use PGT in triangle AOV. This is triangle AOB. Here AB is hypotenuse. Hypotenuse square is equal to the sum of squares of other two sides, and the other two sides are OA and OB. OA and OB. This is question number 3. Now by Pythagoras theorem in triangle VOC, here BC is hypotenuse, therefore BC square is equal to OB square and OC square. This is question number 4. Again by Pythagoras theorem in right triangle COD, here hypotenuse is CD and the other two sides are OC and OD, therefore CD square is equal to OC square plus OD square. And finally by Pythagoras theorem in right triangle DOA, here hypotenuse is AD and other two sides are OA and OD, therefore AD square is equal to OD square plus OA squares. And these are question number 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now we will add these four equations, and in the left side we will get AB square plus BC square plus CD square plus AD square, and in the right side we will get OA square plus OB square plus OB square plus OC square plus OC square plus OD square plus OD square plus OA square. This question. And here we can see that OA square is two times. Once at the first place and once at the last place. This is OA square. That is we have two times OA square. Also OB square plus OB square, 2 OB square. Then this OC square and this OC square, 2 OC square. And this OD square and this OD square, 2 OD square. Now we will use equation number 1 and equation number 2. In equation number 1 we have OA equal to OC, and in equation number 2 we have OB equal to OD. That is we will write OA square for OC and OB square for OD. This 2 OA square and this 2 OB square comes as such, and we have written 2 OA square for this 2 OC square, because in question number 1 we have OC equal to OA and in question number 2 we have OD equal to OB. So here we write 2 OB square for this 2 OD square, because OD and OB are equal in equation number 2. In the next step we get 4 times OA square. This 2 OA square plus this 2 OA square makes 4 times OA square, and this 2 OB square plus this 2 OB square makes 4 OB square, and this 4 OA square can be written as 2 OA square, because 2 square is 4 and OA square is OA square, and this 4 OB square is also written as 2 times OB square. Now this 2 OA can be written as OA plus OA, and this 2 OB can be written as OB plus OB, and squares came as such. Now we have written OC for OA, because in question number 1 we have OC equal to OA, so we write OC for this OA, and this OA has come as such. Here also this OB has come as such, and this OB is written as OD, because in question number 2 we have OB equal to OD. Now OA plus OC will be AC and OB plus OD will be BD. This we can see from figure. OA plus OC, this is OA, this is OC, and both these together makes AC, and this is OB and this is OD, and together we get BD for OB plus OD. In this way we have proved that sum of the squares of sides of a rhombus is equal to the sum of squares of its diagonal.